Okay, I'm back, Stephen Key here, and today I want to talk a little bit about a story about rejection and how sometimes you just have to keep on pushing forward. And this quote, I'm going to say this quote that someone gave me, and I'm going to talk about when that happened. The quote was, "Mr. Key, we're not going to pay you one penny for your idea." Holy jeez, when I heard that quote, I was in the technical center in Procter & Gamble, and someone said that to me once I made my pitch of my rotating label, but I'm jumping ahead. I want to start at the beginning a little bit. I was coming up with a lot of ideas, a lot of novelty gift ideas. I came up with the Michael Jordan wall ball, but one day when I was reading the paper in Modesto, California, it was the Modesto Bee, and they talked about how this one article talked about how there was never enough space on a label. James, please put the article up there so everybody can see it. It was written by Al Gore. And I was inspired. In fact, I was excited. I was pumped up. I went down to Walmart. I grabbed a container. I went to Kinko's. I ripped off that label. And I made this rotating label that provided more information. That was the big problem. Labels don't have enough information, and my rotating label provided 75% more space for that additional information. And I was really excited about it. And sure enough, I made all these prototypes, and I started to pitch them to companies, big companies in the United States. And I pitched them to over 100 companies. James, please put that awful picture up on the screen. That's my dining room table. That's over 15 feet long, and those are all 100 rejection letters. I didn't give up. I was still pretty excited about it, although I was getting rejected right and left by everybody. Sure enough, I got a call from the office of Dirk Jaeger. Dirk Jaeger was the president and CEO of Procter & Gamble, and his office called. They had seen a sample. A friend of mine showed the president, CEO of Procter & Gamble, a sample on a golf. They were golfing. He pulled it out, showed him the rotating label, and he said, "Hey, I want to see the guy that created this in Cincinnati." So sure enough, I get the call. I'm excited. You got to be kidding me. Finally, someone called me. So I told my wife, Janice, I said, "Look, let's go to Cincinnati and let me help me pitch this." She was, at the time, vice president of marketing for Gallo Winery. I needed a marketing person there. I brought a manufacturing person there. And I went out to make my pitch because they wanted me out there in Cincinnati at their technical group at P&G. And I'll never forget, I was walking across, the gentleman that invited me took me out to lunch, Janice and I, before the meeting. And we had lunch in the cafeteria on campus, and we were walking across the grass to get to the technical center. And I remember it like it was yesterday because the sun was shining, and I felt like $1 million. I finally felt like I'd made the big time. I made it. And I thanked him for lunch. And I, you know, and he said to me, "Steve, don't forget one thing." He said, "There's no such thing as a free lunch." That's when I knew something wasn't going to go right. And that's when Janice looked over at me and was like, "I told you so, this isn't going to go well." So sure enough, I get in there, and I'm in there going to make a presentation. All the people from Procter & Gamble line up. There's technical people, marketing people, legal people. There's probably 15 to 20 people on their side and three of us on our side of the table. And I do my little pitch of the label. Janice talks a little bit about the marketing, and the manufacturing guy says, basically, you know, "We can do it." And they didn't say anything. There wasn't one smile on anybody's face. They had set me up. Yes, Procter & Gamble had set me up. And the gentleman slid a piece of paper across the table to me. And I'm going to show you that too up there. And those were all prior art. Those are all prior patents that now I had to show my attorneys. And guess what? I didn't know what was on those, but after he said, "Mr. Key," that's when he said it. "Mr. Key, we're not going to pay you one penny for your idea." And they all got up and they walked out the door. I mean, I flew all the way out there and did all this presentation, and they were just there to do that to me. And sure enough, I didn't really understand it. I got home from the trip and I sent that paper over to my attorneys, and they said, you know, Steve, I'm really sorry, but they found the prior art. They found two patents. In fact, I'll show you up on the screen with one of the patents that were exactly like my idea. And Procter & Gamble was there to kind of embarrass me. And that's why they said, we're not going to pay one penny. And they did their homework, and they thought they were really putting the screws to me. And they basically did. In fact, looking over their agenda for that day, it had all this nice fluffy stuff, but that was not their intention. So, but they did me a favor. At the time, maybe I didn't feel that way because my attorneys told me to forget it. And there was these two prior arts that they weren't a little bit like my idea. They were exactly like my idea. So I didn't know what to do, but I kept on reading the patents because I knew something was wrong. Even though there was a patent on this idea, why did anybody do it? So what were the issues? Why P&G called because the president was interested, but there was patents, but it didn't make sense to me. So I read that patent application, and I realized there was no method of manufacturing. So I figured it out, and I went ahead and figured out a way to manufacture it. And, you know, about a year and a half later, I figured it out, and the product was selling at all the Walmarts. There's a picture of myself and my daughter at Walmart. Here's a commercial of people dancing at Walmart. Come on,
baby. Let's do the twist. Come on, miss. You love twisting, man. We're twisting. We're learning. We're twisting. We're learning. We're twisting.
And here's a commercial of Alex Trebek promoting it. It was in all the Walmarts.
Sundown Herbals presents its remarkable Twist and Learn label. It works like an herbal information center that helps you learn about herbs simply by turning the label. Sundown's new Twist and Learn label, where to turn for help.
So I guess what I'm saying is the moral to the story. Is there a moral to the story, Steve? Yes, there is. If people are telling you no or rejecting you, or maybe they're just telling you that you cannot do it, maybe they're trying to hold you back, or maybe they just don't believe you can. And I know it's not easy, but I'm here to tell you, you can do it. And that's why I'm so excited to share these experiences with you, because I realized, yes, you can do this. And yes, it's going to take a little bit of work. And yes, you're going to get rejected. And yes, there's going to be people that are going to tell you no. That doesn't matter. What you need to do is to believe in yourself. And keep on watching these videos. I'm going to keep on sharing these stories with you. This is Stephen Key. Thank you for letting me go back in time and tell this story once again. I kind of chuckle now because here they thought they were causing problems for me, but they really gave me the keys to the kingdom. And I cannot thank you enough, Procter & Gamble.